Hello, fellow YouTubers. This is going to be one of those functional videos that's not really pretty, but it's going to hopefully give you some information that you'd like to know about the difference between the Milt Sparks Nexus, which is on the upper left, and the Milt Sparks VM2, which is the black holster, on the right. I'm not going to get into a lot of detail because you can read that on the websites, but I want to show you the difference between how they fit on me. And I'm a guy, I'm about 42 years old, and I've got some love handles, so I think a lot of guys out there are probably pretty similar to me in body style, body shape. I'm about 6'2", and I weigh about 215, 220 last time I checked, so I might be a little bit kind to myself on those estimates. But anyway, the difference really between the Nexus, you can see it has a little bit more cant to it than the VM2 does. Also, the Nexus has these magnetic-style straps, and they do their job. They do hold it really tight. Of course, you want to keep that magnet away from things like electronic media and things that might get erased, because they are very powerful magnets. It's got horse on the back. I believe that's standard, and I asked for cow on the front, which I think is also standard anyway. The same with the VM2, horse on the back, cow on the front. And the reason they put horse on the back is it repels water much better than cow does. So that's a great feature, and looks great anyway. So you can take a good quick close look at these two holsters. I'll flip them around again so you can look. And they always stamp the maker's initials there in the holsters. They do have open ends on them on the bottom, slightly open. They're very nice, well-made, heavy holsters. The VM2, by the way, does have reinforcement here, which makes the gun easy to pull in and out if you're doing something like practicing holstering and reholstering. That's not so easy with the new Nexus. There is no reinforcement there. It's not something that you can easily reholster with one hand, although it can be done. It's not something you want to practice holstering and reholstering with a lot. In terms of, you know, just trying for speed or something like that. It's meant more for concealment. Okay, I do have a couple of Milt Sparks belts here. The black belt is 1.5 inches. The light brown tan belt is 1.25 inches. And I decided to go with 1.25 inches because I felt it was more of a dressy look. I might oil that a little bit or something to darken it up, because I like a little darker leather than that, but it's really not a big deal. Anyway, let me go ahead and move on and show you what these look like on my body. And again, I apologize for the fat rolls. Here we go. Okay, and welcome back. I'm in the bathroom here, and I'm wearing the VM2 on my black belt here. And get things straightened up a little bit there. Sorry about that. But we'll take a look at that. You can see my 1911 Commander is in there. I didn't mention that this is the Commander size. It's a Smith & Wesson 1911 SC bobtail. Or rounded butt, I guess they call it. The VM2 fits quite nicely, actually. I'll try to turn around there. But what I notice about the VM2 more is it rides higher. It does ride higher. And for me, the bottom end of the gun, the butt, I guess you'd say, sticks out just ever so bit, a little bit more. And that to me makes it print a bit more than the Nexus. And that's kind of why I went with the Nexus the second time around. Let me try to hold this, and I'm going to try to straighten things up here. And I'm going to turn a bit, and maybe you can see some printing there of the gun. Kind of hard for me to do this and see what I'm doing. You see that printing in there? Maybe it's not enough that you would even care or worry about, but see, there's the gun right there, okay? And here is the butt. Right, so I'm going to turn around, try to do some more turning, and maybe you can see some printing. The VM2 for me fits really well if I've got it right up against my hip. The problem, though, and I'll pull the shirt tight so you can see it well. Problem again is that back end kind of pokes out, and especially if I bend down. Gosh, I can't see if you can see it. If I bend down, then I can really see it. And as I wear it, I notice that it tends to want to slide back a little bit, and I find myself kind of adjusting that guy forward a little bit because I want to hide that little bit in the back, okay? But again, it's, you know, maybe I'm just being too picky. But that is what it does, and I've got a nice loose shirt here.
That's the VM2. I'm going to pull it up here, have you look at it a little bit better, a little bit more closely. See if I can move this camera around here. I really can't see what I'm seeing. Maybe you can see something better. I'm not really sure. Give it a try. Maybe if I look in the mirror. No. Anyway, moving on around. That was a big fail, wasn't it? Moving around here, you can take another close look at that. And maybe I'll move forward a bit. Okay, so that's where she sits. Now, again, that's the only part I'm really concerned about there, is that sticking back. And as I mentioned, over time, it seems to want to slide back a little bit. And then it sticks a little bit more in the back, and I can see it more. It starts to print more for me. I just find that now I find myself having to readjust a little bit. And if I pull the belt really tight, then that helps. But it still kind of does that. One more thing I can notice is when I sit down in a truck or a car, the VM2 is a little less comfortable than the Nexus. For some reason, the Nexus seems to be canted forward more and fits right there in that 90 degree or so angle that the seats make. I guess it's not 90, but pretty close. So the Nexus is better in that sense. Okay, and back again here. Now I'm wearing the Nexus, and want to mention that the Nexus, because of the cant, I believe, it allows me to ride the holster forward a little bit more on my body, and it gets rid of that butt mark there on the holster, except when I turn a lot here, you might see it more. I'm really turning a lot like I did with the VM2, and it's harder to see. Here's the gun right here, okay? It's right there, so you can see where it's printing. And I'll pull it up here, and you see it kind of rides a lot lower, or a bit lower anyway, in the holster. And the butt here is pushed right up against my love handle. And maybe that's kind of nice, because it kind of pushes in a little bit and seems to help. Let me put this in the other hand and try to do this. Yeah, there we go. It seems to kind of help hide the gun a little bit more. And I like that. I like that. And like I said, I can ride this forward more on my hip bone. Actually, this is setting forward so much more that my hip bone is kind of right down in the middle of the gun. And because it's a commander-size gun, it's not really causing a problem. But you know what? I think a standard-size 1911 would feel just fine, to be honest. But there's the hip bone right there. I'm able to slide it forward more and hide that gun more. See, look at that. I can hide the back of that. And I like that about the Nexus. That's really why I bought it. I was always bugged by the fact that that little bit stuck out there when I was walking around or whatever. And by the way, I do have my carry license, so I'm in the state of Iowa, and I do have my CCW. And anyway, there you are. Gives a much better, I'll pull it tight again, a much better hide there. Hides it much better, doesn't it? Sorry, I'm shaky here. I'm holding this Samsung Galaxy Note and recording this. But it does a pretty good job of hiding it. Now from the side, is there more bulge? No, not really. And it doesn't have that extra little flap of leather that doesn't make a lot of difference, but makes, because the Nexus doesn't have that extra leather reinforcement there, it is more difficult to holster and reholster and unholster, sorry. And you'll notice this too, and this is brand new, so it's not broken in yet, but it is quite a bit harder to pull that guy out of there. And I know I didn't do that with the VM2, but the VM2 does come out much more easily and also go in a bit more easily too. But hey, you know, for CCW, I figure if I'm ever pulling my gun out, there's a darn good reason why, and that's it. Otherwise, the thing ain't coming out until I get home. So that's the reason why I prefer the Nexus over the VM2. Anything else I can tell you about this? As I mentioned, this is a 1¼-inch belt that does seem plenty to hold it. It's just fine. If I had it to do it again, I probably would get the 1½, just for cosmetic reasons, I guess. The 1¼ looks fine. But I don't know. I guess I prefer a 1½. Now that I've tried the two, but in terms of holding the gun, it's just fine. The metal snaps hold everything just with no problems. It is easier to get on and off because it has these magnetic metal straps, as opposed to the VM2, which uses these kind of, I guess you'd call them button snaps. And to be honest, I find the button snaps quite nasty. I don't like them at all. They do hold very well. I know they're supposed to break in over time, But the button snaps on my VM2 are not easy to put on. And yes, I do know how to put them on and do to put them on correctly, but they're still not easy. And I know they'll break in over time, but I guess I'm just lazy and don't want to waste the time. But I do love the magnets. They're great. Easy to pull on and off. Easier holster to get on and off. You can always thread the belt through it too, so it's not a big deal. If you go with a VM2 and you don't like the snaps, it's not a problem because you can just thread your belt through just about as quick anyway. So there you go. I hope that gave you some knowledge that you didn't have before, and I apologize for the shaky video, and I apologize that I'm not the best videographer here and I'm just doing a quickie job. But I didn't see anything on YouTube comparing these two holsters in terms of fit. So hopefully this helps you just a little bit and helps you make a decision. They're both great holsters, and I like Milt Sparks products, and they've got good customer service. So anyway, good luck and have a good day.